Hi, welcome back to another Princess Connect video. My name is Lace, and today we're going to be talking about the Little Lyrical Adventures event, as well as doing a quick character evaluation of Kyoka, who is the upcoming banner unit. This is not the Little Lyrical Adventures event, I just wanted to show you because it was a little bit creepy. So on the Japanese server, what's pretty cool is that there is actually like an events compendium in which I can access a lot of the previous events. So here we go into the Little Lyrical Adventures. So today I'm going to be giving you a quick run through the event. It's largely the same as the previous event and largely will be the same as the next few events as well. I'll be talking about priorities and how you should kind of farm this event. All in all, the event side of the video, it should be pretty straightforward, pretty short. Then I'm going to talk about Kyoka and give a quick evaluation and see kind of like where she kind of fits in with the CB and the arena landscape. Let's jump into the video, and I can do that by clicking into the event. Without further ado, let's talk about who is featured on the Little Lyrical Adventures. So the Little Lyrical Adventures Guild is actually composed of Misogi, Mimi, and Kyoka. As most of us already know, Kyoka is a 3-star unit who will be featured in the upcoming banner. As for Mimi and Misogi, we'll actually be able to farm these two units. So Misogi is a 1-star support midliner, and Mimi is also a midliner unit that does a surprising amount of damage and has some pretty cool effects. Mimi herself, however, is a 2-star, so it will take a little bit more shards to level her up. By now, hard shard farming is almost over, and I hope you guys have gotten your Mimi to at least about like 2-3 stars, because you'll definitely be able to get a next star. All right, with that being said, let's jump into the event. It's very, very similar to the Hatsune event, so it will come back to normal. You see, it is the same thing. Stages 1 through to 15, first clear bonuses, and then there's a whole bunch of like gemmies and all of that. So what's happening as you clear through 1 to 15 is you're actually getting boss tickets, in which you use those boss tickets to then challenge the boss. After you clear stage 15, you fight the normal boss, which is unavailable. Okay, then we'll go into the hard. And here you see the actual distribution of the hard shards. So it's 3 Mimi nodes and 2 Misogi nodes. Unfortunately, I cleared the hard boss here, but this is not what happens when we get it. This is just what happens when you clear an event in the event compendium kind of thing. So by and large, all 3 bosses kind of look like this guy. So he's kind of like a teapot scorpion dude. Nothing really crazy about him. If you guys could clear the first event, you guys will clear the second event for sure. For you guys that are more new to the game, I would suggest using like a clan battle. Actually, if you're new, you wouldn't know what a clan battle team is. It's a pretty standard team to clear this. So you're looking at like at least 1 tank, probably 2 DPS, 1 support, and 1 healer in the back. The comp that I ran for the last event was Jun, Kaori, Makoto, Shiori, and Yui. I'm going to be running the same one this event, and I should be able to get a 1 turn pretty fast. So a commonly asked question is, at what point do I clear the hard boss versus the normal boss? So I know that a lot of the newer players fight the normal boss and then they're like, oh, this is so much easier, can I just do this? My answer to all of this is that as long as you're able to clear the hard boss in about 2 to 3 runs, you should always do the hard boss. When you clear the boss, you get medals, and you use those medals to actually roll in the item gacha. So just quickly back to this guy. So the item gacha is over here, and then you've got a whole bunch of medals, and then you're clearing out the boxes, right? So if we have a look at this, you have a whole bunch of shards and a whole bunch of stuff in here. I have 14 medals here, so therefore if I rolled 14 times, let's just do it. So let's see what we get. And we get a whole bunch of items, right? What needs to happen is that you have to clear the compulsory stuff, which is usually only the shards, which is located at the very top. If you clear the compulsory stuff, you can move on to the next box. There are 5 boxes that kind of look like this, but each box has like some varying items. So what should you do with the boxes then? My advice is to actually finish box 1 as fast as possible. So if we have a quick look at Fansomething's website, he's got the list of all of the boxes from 1 through to 5. You can see box 1 has the Misogi shards, it's 20 of them, and then we've got 25 Mimi shards here, 30 Misogi shards. Box 4 has 40 Mimi shards, and then box 5 onwards is your unlimited one. What I'm trying to say is that once you've actually picked up the Misogi shards, you can actually ignore the rest of it and move on. This is an option, you don't have to do it if you want, but this is what I would do. Typically for box 1, I try to get the shards as soon as possible to actually reset into box 2. Then in box 2, 3, and 4, I actually try to clear as much of it as I can. From box 5 onwards, it's kind of whatever because it's an infinite box. You kind of have to clear everything before you can reset it. So there's actually not an option when you get to box 5. Some people do try to grind out for the jewels and divine amulets in box 1, but I don't think it's worth it. And why I don't think it's worth it is because of the way that I play the event, and I'll introduce you to that pretty shortly. So yeah, to summarize the approach for rolling the boxes, get the Misogi shard from the box 1 ASAP and then reset when you can. Box 2, 3, and 4, the ratios are pretty good on all of the items, so I would recommend clearing them all. Box 5, you have to clear all of it, so there's no option here. So if I come back over here, we've got a whole bunch of these hard stages, right? So which one should we farm? I know in a lot of my videos, I've actually said that Misogi is relatively not not used. I don't want to say she's useless because I've seen some pretty mean builds and like I've gotten bombed by her pretty hard before, which have led to inevitable arena losses. My advice for clearing the event is to actually clear all of the hard mode shards every single day. This actually gives you a whole bunch of boss tickets, and if you can actually finish the hard boss in one turn, you should be able to clear the event exactly how I described it, especially with the treasure boxes thing. If you can only do hard in like two or more, then I would consider actually doing a couple of runs on the 115. However, I wouldn't run the 115 unless you're like really, really desperate. In my opinion, as long as you've got the shards for box one and you finish box two, three, and four, you're kind of done with the event. All of that stamina, you could put it into 115 and run the bosses more. Or you could actually put it somewhere else because Clan Battle 3 is coming up. And you may notice this very hard boss, I don't think we'll be getting it in our iteration. This will come one day, but probably not with our upcoming event. All right, guys, unfortunately, I didn't have the pleasure of rolling Kyoka, so I'm gonna have to refer to her on the wiki. So here we've got Kyoka, and Kyoka is a 3-star natural single target mage. I think she's one of the first of her kind where like she just kind of nukes everything with her all of her skills. Currently in the game, we do have Akari, who is kind of the closest thing to a single target mage. However, Akari is more of a support, especially when her Yubi doesn't even do much damage, if any at all, actually. So Kyoka herself, she will one day be farmable via 16-3, which is about like 5 months away if we assume that we are going to be getting a story mode every month. Let's have a quick run through her skills, and they're pretty busted to be honest. So let's start with a Union Burst, which is just big damage. The key thing is that it is large magic damage to one enemy in the front. When she gets her UE, her critical damage multiplier actually doubles, which makes it a really, really strong skill. Eventually in the game, we're going to start getting crit boosters and stuff, so Kyoka scales really, really nicely with her UE. As for skill 1, she inflicts medium damage to one enemy in the front. And her skill 2, she just gives herself an M attack buff. The X skill, she just gets more and more damage. I think you guys are getting the point. She does really, really big damage. Look at all that. It's a magic attack, magic crit rate. It's all there is. In a nutshell, she will nuke the thing that is most frontmost. This is a pretty important distinction because one of the mages that we have that's very popular right now is Hatsune. Hatsune actually targets the highest physical attack unit on the enemy team. So what that means is that Hatsune is not that effective against, like, for example, Miyako comps. Ana, on the other hand, always targets from front to back, and Kyoka is more like that. If you're looking for a Miyako Slayer, this is your next Miyako Slayer. All right, if I could digress a bit, last thing I want to talk about before getting into the applications is actually the attack pattern. So I love this attack pattern. Kyoka is just incredible. Every time she casts her skill, she will buff before then. This just makes sure that every time she nukes somebody, she will like really nuke them. Obviously, the key thing to pay attention is before you cast your UB, especially in clan battle, you want to make sure that you have the attack buff first. Also, what it does mean is that if you accidentally animation cancel one of these skills, it is a massive DPS loss. The last thing to note, I suppose, is that she recently got her 6-star and she is still a massive nuker. Nothing's really changed. It's just that from now until the 6-stars, a lot of the characters actually gets overloaded with effects. 6-star Kyoka actually helps her like kind of match those modern units. But this is not something you should be worrying about because this is actually going to be like 3 years away. All right, applications in terms of like arena, clan battle, story, whatever. For story, she is just like your solid like damage dealer. You need a mage. You got to hit those turtles. She is your girl. Otherwise, you do need to be prepared for those freaking things that throw axes or whatever that hit the position 5 units. It's quite probable that your mages, especially your Kyoka, is actually going to occupy the position 5 space. Therefore, she's going to get chunked by those axe throwing or whatever like position 5 attackers. As for arena, she is going to be another option for mage melt. For you guys who don't know what mage melt is, it's typically one tank, Monica, and 3 mages. The tank is typically Nozomi or whoever you need to tech in. They're pretty much just there to make sure that your mages live fast enough to melt the other team. Monica is to give the rest of the team a big juicer to make sure that they also melt the enemy team. Those 3 mages are typically occupied by like Io, Io, I still don't know which one's the right one. Ana, Hatsune, Akari, Yori, and Kyoka could definitely be a new one. You take Kyoka when you have confidence that you can actually go front to back really fast. Hatsune in particular is when you want to nuke one of those enemy high physical attack units. For Kyoka, your idea has to kind of be like, well, I'm going to melt these tanks real fast and then keep going. Kyoka's kit is very, very straightforward. It's just damage, 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 damage. And so you can't really do like really, really tricky stuff with it. As for clan battle, this is an interesting one because I know a couple of my clanmates want to use her in the upcoming clan battle. So this is an extract of the stats of the first clan battle where you can see that Flower actually has 140 less magical defense than it does physical defense. Now, this is actually pretty massive because like what this means is that even though there is a lack of magic defense down. The only magic defense down unit that you can use right now is Akari and potentially Kiaru. Despite all of that, and combining that with Kyoka, that team might actually like really, really fry this boss. Clan Battle 3 is coming up and one of the bosses will be the flower again. So that is actually definitely something you should think about. I can't remember if this was actually 100% correct, but it's more the logic, right? If you have a boss that has much, much less MDef, you can definitely consider using a mage team. The problem with mage teams even now is that there's no real like consistent source of magic defense down. You got Makoto, you got Jun, you got Mitsuki, you got Shinobu, they all give like a lot of defense down. So for Clan Battle 3, the only scenario that I would probably use Kyoka is if like it's this kind of difference. If there really is like a difference of 140 magic defense, then I would definitely bring the magic comp into this. So what could the magic comp look like? So it's probably a mixture of like a tank, and then you've got Kyoka, and then you need Akari. One big tech that you could do is Akari UB into Kyoka UB, in which Kyoka would be massively healed. Other than that, you could take Kokoro, you could take Anna, you could take Hatsune, you could take Kiaru. You could even take Yui, to be honest, if you don't have enough sustain. And she does actually have a skill one or a skill two where it's a single target magic attack. I'm not saying it's going to be game breaking, but it is definitely an option when you see those stats. Clan Battle 3, I'll be coming out with a preparation video very, very shortly. So just stay tuned and I'll just go into more detail there. So now the question is, should you roll for Kyoka? There are a lot of people that are rolling her because they really like her, and you know what, like freaking do it. However, what we do need to remember is that Kyoka is going to be followed by Ilya banner, which is going to be kind of followed like a little bit in the distant future by Summer Kiaru banner. On the Ilya banner, there is an opportunity to be spooked by Kyoka. On the Summer Kiaru banner, there's opportunity to be spooked by Ilya and Kyoka. However, the raid up rate on these raid ups, did that make sense? It's actually abysmally low. So if you want Kyoka, my recommendation is that you pull for her now. I really don't think that you should go pull for Ilya and pray for a Kyoka spook. Honestly, I don't think that's going to happen. If you want Kyoka, you get her now. Between Ilya or Kyoka, I probably am going to like trend towards Kyoka. I'm more of a CB focused person, and I'm not really interested in Ilya's ability to kill herself and the fact that you need her at 5 stars to actually let her work. And that's if I'm falling for Kyoka. We'll see. We'll see. But yeah, I don't think there's going to be like another magical single target damage dealer like Kyoka for a little bit. We've got Summer Kiaru coming up, but she's more like a Makoto than anything. Kyoka is more like your Kari. Actually, when I put it like that, I think I'm going to pull for her. Again, guys, clan battle focus is going to be Kyoka. PvP, it's going to be Ilya. Pretty much everybody should be rolling for Summer Kiaru. And that kind of brings us to the end of the video because I don't think there's anything left to talk about. All right, guys, I have a secret message. Actually, it's more of a secret question. I want to know if you're rolling for Kyoka. I'll probably put a few tickets into it, but I probably won't spark her. Let me know how you guys are feeling and what you guys are going to do for Kyoka. Otherwise, there's nothing left to be said except if you've enjoyed this video or this video has helped you, please consider sharing, liking, subscribing, following, pinning, whatever. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.